Match game 74, production era 0153. Air date to be announced 2274, take one. Get ready to match the stars. Larry Blyden. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Kaye Stevens. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
How is everybody over here today?
You look beautiful.
Lovely.
So lovely.
And
thank you, my dear. Tell me more.
Your vision in gray.
Romance, romance. I didn't know this was a sex.
You're all terrific. Listen, you ready to go? What do you have to say for yourself today? You.
Well, I've got to get a move on. I'm due to do Captain Kangaroo in a half an hour.
Okay, let's welcome our two players, Ronnie Schwartz and Paul Fisher. Hello there, Paul. We have finished a round and a half of this game. Ronnie has finished two of her questions. She's matched all six celebrities, and Paul's got his work cut out for him. He's got to match five celebrities to achieve a tie and stay in the game. And we'll see what happens right after we find out about this message for you. Here we go. I will push the button and reveal a question for Paul Fisher, our current champ, who has won $10,200 so far. And in the first round of this game, he matched Richard Dawson, and now he will attempt to match every other celebrity to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Good luck, Paul. Here we go. Everybody but Dickie. While the Lone Ranger was asleep, Tonto got up and blanked him. You like that one?
Yeah.
While the Lone Ranger was asleep, Tonto got up and blanked him. You thinking about that, Paul? Okay.
Tonto got something strange about that, Tonto.
All right, Brett and Larry are ready. Charles, we're waiting for you. And let's see. Elaine is finished. Kaye is finished.
It's hard to get Charles to put his answer in the slot, dear.
Yes. Well, he'll get the hang of it by the time we're in our
second
year.
I speak very little English.
All right, Paul Fisher. While the Lone Ranger was asleep, Tonto got up and blanked him.
I'm going to go with scalped.
Scalped him. All right. The first time we get an answer other than scalp, the game is over. He's got a match.
Go
what do you
ahead,
say, Kimosabe?
It's been wonderful knowing you, Paul. Creamed.
It creamed him. So that's the next game. Ronnie Schwartz is the winner. Come on now, Ronnie. Congratulations. Stand by for a moment here. We've got to say goodbye to Paul Fisher. Your wife is still smiling down there.
It's been a delightful experience.
Well, it's been a pleasure for us to meet you as your wife and her mother and cousins. And we brought the whole family here for good luck. Good luck to you, Paul Fisher. $10,200. So long, Paul. Well, Ronnie, Paul has left a very, very happy man with all of that money, and we're going to see how happy you're going to be now.
I hope so.
You're the champ. You've got $100 to your credit now. You're going to have a go at over $5,000 in the Big Money Super Match here. Are you ready for that?
I sure am. I've got my lucky gardenia.
Okay. May I have a little whiff of your gardenia?
Yes.
Great, great odor, isn't it?
Okay.
All right, here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, Ronnie, and we got their best response to this. Rub blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second most frequent response, $250. Third, $100. Which celebrities would you like a little assist from?
Chuck, please. Charles.
Oh, Chuck. Charles. She calls
Chuck.
You Chuck.
Hey, Chuck. Because when I wear ruffles, I get very confused.
I'll buy that, with or without the ruffles.
I say, a Chuck would say an answer like rub-a-dub.
Rub-a-dub. Okay. So Chuck says rub-a-dub. How come
you're
like
that gardenia in my face, lady, yes, if my name is Chuck?
Throw a brick my way.
Chuck, may I ask a question? Your light is on. How come?
Because I'm Chuck. That's a stupid question.
You've never touched
it was kissed, was what Tom Joe did.
Oh, I see.
Tom will kiss
the Lone Ranger. Yeah, Chuck, that's not his. Yeah, now let's get another one, shall we?
I'm sorry. From now on, you'll be Charles. How
you
about
say
Dickie?
Say anything you want.
He's only kidding.
It's your gardenia.
Okay. Dickie?
Yeah, something.
I've got to point out.
Do you want my ruffles?
That you're not playing a game called What's in a Name.
Mr. Dawson really prefers
Dickie.
Richard, not
or
Dickie.
Chuck. I don't mind Chuck. I
hate Dickie. He really doesn't like
Dickie. I don't even mind Evelyn. I just hate Dickie.
No, we're
only
fooling
you. Call me, sir. Rub down.
Rub down.
Very good.
One more.
Larry, please.
Larry.
Go on, Larry.
Is that your real name?
No, my real name is Alice.
I thought it was Charles.
What do you say? How do you feel?
Rubber.
Rubber.
Oh, that's the worst answer.
Oh. That's a rough answer. Isn't that a rough answer?
What do you expect from an Alice?
No, listen. No, we don't know whether that's a good answer or a bad answer, but that's his answer. So you've got rubber, rub-a-dub-dub, and rub-down. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own, Ronnie. What would you like to do?
I'll take Richard's rub-down.
Take Richard's rub-down.
I'll have you through in 30 minutes.
He does it with perfumed oils and all that. It's very interesting.
Gardenia
like
behind
that?
My ear.
Okay. Rub down is the answer we're looking for. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response. Rub out is a good answer. Okay, very good answer. Still no rub down. Let's see if it's under the $250 response. Rub down it is. You've got it. Congratulations. Okay. Now, before we go on, what do you think is under the $500?
Rub-a-dub-dub.
Yeah, you think rub-a-dub-dub is under? Yeah. Here it is, a $500 response. Rub-a-dub-dub is right. Audience is right all along. Got a very smart bunch out there. Okay, now you've got $250. That means you're going to be playing for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. Remember to collect. You got to match one celebrity head-to-head. It has to be exact. Choose one now, please.
Richard, please.
Richard, it is. You face me, if you would, please. Alice, Marjorie, Charlie, whatever. He's going to write his answer.
His here name is Evelyn. He told you that before.
No. This is Ronnie here, and that's Richard. Born blank. That's B-O-R-N blank. Born blank. There. May I have this dance? Okay, Richard has finished his answer, and now, Ronnie, we need a response from you that you think will match his. Born
free.
Well, the audience is rooting for you, and they think you're right, too, with that. We'll find out right now for $2,500. Alice, may we see your answer? Evelyn, I beg your pardon.
Please. Well, Cynthia, I'm going to level with you.
What?
It never even entered my mind. All I could think of, Judy Holliday and Born...
What? Together, we got a little message for you, and this is it. Congratulations.
GSN presents
Gene Ranner.
Old Man Periwinkle was just a spontaneous creation.
Get that girl to come over here a little closer.
Dumb Dora, I think that was spontaneous too. Dumb Dora was so dumb, then the audience would just jump right in and say, how dumb was she?
Stay tuned for more of That 70s Hour on GSN.
Everything we did was spontaneous.
Hello there. We're ready to start another game. Are you calm down now?
Oh, I'm thrilled.
You think the gardenia really brought you luck?
I know it did.
Well, we're very happy for you. You've got a lot of money there now. And now you're going to be challenged by this lady. Let's welcome Susie Backus. Hi, Susie.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, thank you.
You're a very chic-looking lady.
Thank you very much.
Can you tell us a little bit about your life?
Yes, I'm married. I have a little girl, and both of us do a little modeling.
You do?
Yes.
How old is your little girl?
She's almost three.
Does she like modeling?
Yeah, she does all right.
Yeah. What kind of modeling do you do?
I work for the garment district when it comes out, and she's with an agency.
I see. Okay. Well, good luck to you here, and good luck to you, Ronnie. Let's push the button and reveal two questions here and ask the challenger to make a selection.
I think I'll have B.
You want B? Everybody plays a brand new game. Folks, here we go.
Where's okay.
The key light? All right, right there. All right.
Show those cheekbones, honey.
That's right. Angelina said, my Pasquale's going to make $1 million. He's invented a way to recycle blank. Angelina said that. My Pasquale, he gonna make $1 million.
Oh, do you do terrific accents.
Can I peek?
If the mafia could find him, they'd lynch him.
Brett and Charles are ready.
I'm ready.
Everybody ready down here?
Yeah.
Larry, you're thinking too hard.
Larry,
I trust your first instinct.
Right,
your instincts are good,
Larry. Not tomorrow, Larry.
Yeah.
Today.
Yeah. Okay. Now, Susie, we call on you. Angelina said, my Pasquale is going to make $1 million. He's invented a way to recycle...
the Eiffel Tower.
I thought I did a pretty good Italian accent, and she says the Eiffel Tower.
Was that bad?
Well, no, I don't know, but that's your answer. My Pasquale is going to make $1 million. He's invented a way to recycle the Eiffel Tower, right. Is your answer. And good luck with it. How do you say to this, sir?
Well, I've found two things. One is that my mind doesn't work like anybody else's, which is a blow.
Yeah.
And the other is that you do terrible accents. Put down pasta.
Pasta, okay? Recycle pasta. Brett?
I a bit of one a spada. That's my Italian accent. It's not good, but I said spaghetti.
Spaghetti would not be a bad answer. Hey. Right. Charles?
E tu, Carlo, dite spaghetti.
Spaghetti, okay. How say you?
Spaghetti.
Spaghetti seems to be the answer. Yep.
Spaghetti.
And Richard?
Spaghetti, by any other name, is a pasta.
Spaghetti, right. We probably match that on the air.
Isn't Charles wonderful?
Quelle la banza sta fagando, non di sondo, non di gambe.
Sì, grazie.
Queste qua.
È vero.
Andiamo a miseria. Spaghetti.
Faccio la finestra.
Eiffel Tower.
All right. Susie didn't score with that. And we'll see how Ronnie does with this. Everybody ready?
I'm ready.
All the tiny people in the valley took cover when the jolly green giant started blanking. We're just having a grand time. It's a good reading, isn't it? I mean, you're a Broadway producer and all that. How was the reading? I mean, did you think you could ever use me in anything?
Sure.
Are you ready over there?
I've been ready for an hour.
What are you doing, Charles?
What are you?
Writing a few letters to friends.
Okay.
I love it.
Now he's all set. So we will call on Ronnie and get her response. All the tiny people in the valley took cover when the jolly green giant started...
going to the bathroom.
What she said is her answer. What's yours?
Walking.
Walking would shake the earth, and the tiny people would get very nervous about that. Brett?
The jolly green giant, and you know how I feel about the jolly green giant. I've spoken to you about it before.
Right.
Now, the jolly green giant had this enormous bell. So when he started tinkling, they all took cover.
It was a nice euphemism, but we matched it anyway, Brett. Charles?
That's not what I had in mind, but I put tinkling anyway.
Well, there's two for you, Ronnie. That surprises me, Elaine. Are you surprised?
Yeah, I don't think the way anyone does either. I said when he was burping.
Burping. That would shake up the tiny people in the valley.
And give you
I understand
the
he has enough gas to get to Pittsburgh.
I said walking.
Walking. Okay. Kaye, may we see it, please? And you have to say
really
it as
laughing
you
laughing gas.
No, I would never. This is terrible. My mother's not going to appreciate that. Sneezing, I said, because
sneezing.
I have class.
Okay.
All third.
So that's two for you. And at the end of round one, it's 2-0 in favor of the champ. And we'll go to round two. But first, we've got to do this for you. Here we go. Finished round one. Score is 2-0 in favor of our current champion. Round two coming up. Susie, would you make a selection?
I'll say B again. I'm going to be smarter.
All right. She wants B. Okay. Everybody plays. As soon as Superman told Lois Lane about his X-ray vision, she lined her blank with lead.
She lined her blank with what, sweetheart?
Lead. See, X-rays will not penetrate lead.
Gotcha.
Got the idea?
I never knew that till this very moment.
You didn't.
You can learn something on this show.
That's true. It's a very educational program.
Yes.
All right. Everybody understood that question.
Oh, my God. You have to do it again.
What?
Sorry. Go ahead.
As soon as Superman told Lois Lane about his X-ray vision, she lined her blank with lead.
Oh, I got it. Oh, okay. Sometimes. Okay. Look at me already. Is everybody else ready?
Yes, everybody's all ready. Okay. Now, Susie, we call on you. As soon as Superman told Lois Lane about his X-ray vision, she lined her blank with lead.
I'll say bra.
Her bra with lead. All right, Larry, she said bra. What do you say?
I have a blanket category which includes bra.
Really?
Undies.
Undies. I'm waiting for the...
How is such a thing not possible?
It's that topless girl again.
That's right. Well, they didn't match it, and that's their decision, not mine. Sorry about that. Brett, what do you say?
So let's throw it away with the rest, dear.
Down the drain.
Where is... Isn't the Eiffel Tower in Paris?
Yes.
I said bra.
Bra, there's a match. No, she had just gotten back from Paris. She was trying to think of the Leaning Tower of Pizza, you see.
Well,
so that's no. That's why that happened. Charles, what did you say?
Bra!
Bra! Sound your A! How about you?
How about me?
Yes. Yeah, I think you're terrific.
Lois Lane didn't wear a bra.
She didn't wear a bra?
Panties.
She didn't. Oh, I see. Okay. All right, I don't see. Not if she lined them with lead. She had lead in her pants.
Yeah.
And Superman says, get the lead out of your pants. I'm sorry to do that to you, Richard.
I love it.
Not at all. Luckily, I couldn't be here today. I'm amazed that this is a very spotty thing. Here we have just the bra line.
Yep.
Huckleberry Dillinger has the panties line.
That's right.
I mean, this lady's very modest. She lined the dress.
The whole dress.
But she didn't want him to see anything.
That's right.
But if you look that way, you can...
Yeah, I see. Well, never mind. All right, Kaye, what came to your pixie mind?
Well, I wouldn't, I mean, bra, I mean, of course she was braless, but she may have a hernia because she lined her panties.
So, the score at this moment is 2-2, and what do? We go on with it. Oh, all right. Ronnie, we've got this. You need one match to win the game. And let's see who does not play. Brett and Charles do not play. Here we go. When the explorers brought the first garbage disposal to the North Pole, an Eskimo stuck his blank in it. When the explorers brought the first garbage disposal to the North Pole, you know what a disposal is, those
things. I know what a disposal is.
An Eskimo stuck his blank in it.
I may not be the smartest person in the world, Gene, but I know what a bloody disposal is.
You probably have one installed in your home.
Yes,
and
I
you don't
do.
Even live in the north.
Yeah, but installed in your mouth.
Okay. Here we go, Ronnie. When the explorers brought the first garbage disposal to the North Pole, an Eskimo stuck his...
penguin.
His penguin in it? Put the penguin right in there, poor bird. Larry, what did you... She said penguin. What do you
say? I thought the hated penguin was in the South Pole.
Yes.
Yeah, so I had him put his blubber.
His blubber in it. That's very good.
Another winner from Larry Blyden.
And Elaine, what did you say?
I thought you would say nose.
Nose. No, no match there, Richard.
Do you hear music, Doctor?
Yes.
I've heard it all day.
We're getting close to the end, that's
why. Not the point. I'm getting threatening letters from Lawrence Welk. Put his hand in it.
Put his hand in it. Oh, that poor Eskimo.
You have a big hand, folks.
Kaye, what do you say?
I'm going to Bangkok with Larry, because I like to think he put his blubber in.
Blubber. Penguin is the answer that she was looking for, so this game ends in a tie, and we'll get back to you in a moment or so and tell you what happens, but first we've got this for you.
Say
goodnight. Team Match Game 74. Join us next time. Bye.
Oh, today's consolation prizes are two sets of Supreme Socket Sets. 78 pieces, including reversible ratchet wrenches in a steel set. Exclusively from Two Value Hardware Store. And Eureka Canister Vacuum Cleaner with powerful fan jet motor. Convenient 7-piece tube pack that Eureka cleans everything from rugs to curtains. And a supply of Airwick solid, including rose, natural, and lemon scents in beautiful decorator colors. Airwick works 24 hours a day to help eliminate odor. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
I think we'll match his Born
Free.
Well, the audience is rooting for you, and they think you're right, too, with that. We'll find out right now for $2,500. Alice, may we see your answer? Evelyn, I beg your pardon.
Please. Well, Cynthia, I'm going to level with you.
What?
It never even entered my mind. All I could think of, Judy Holliday and Born...
What? Together, we got a little message for you, and this is it. Congratulations.
GSN presents...
Old Man Periwinkle was just a spontaneous creation. Get that girl to come over here a little closer. Dumb Dora, I think that was spontaneous too. Dumb Dora was so dumb, and the audience would just jump right in and say, how dumb was she?
Stay tuned for more of That 70s Hour on GSN.
Everything we did was spontaneous.
Hello there. We're ready to start another game. Are you calmed down now?
Oh, I'm thrilled.
You think the gardenia really brought you luck?
I know it did.
Well, we're very happy for you. You've got a lot of money there now. And now you're going to be challenged by this lady. Let's welcome Susie Backus. Hi, Susie.
Hi.
Hi.
Thank you.
You're a very chic-looking lady.
Thank you very much.
Can you tell us a little bit about your life?
Yes, I'm married. I have a little girl, and both of us do a little modeling.
You do?
Yes.
How old is your little girl?
She's almost 3.
Does she like modeling?
Yeah, she does all right.
Match Game 74, production era 0153. Air date to be announced 2274, take one. Get ready to match the stars. Larry Blyden. Brett Somers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Kaye Stevens, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Yeah. beautiful.
Marcy, yes. Lovely.
Thank you, my dear. Tell me more.
Your vision in gray.
Romance, romance.
I didn't know this was a sex.
You're all terrific. Listen, you're ready to go? What do you have to say for yourself today? You, with
well, I've got to get a move on. I'm due to do Captain Kangaroo in a half an hour.
Okay, let's welcome our two players, Ronnie Schwartz and Paul Fisher. Hello there, Paul. Now, we have finished a round and a half of this game. Ronnie has finished two of her questions. She's matched all six celebrities, and Paul's got his work cut out for him. He's got to match five celebrities to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Everybody. And we'll see what happens right after we find out about this message for you. Here we go. I will push the button and reveal a question for Paul Fisher, our current champ, who has won $10,200 so far. And in the first round of this game, he matched Richard Dawson, and now he will attempt to match... What do you say? How do you feel?
Rubber.
Rubber.
Oh, that's the worst answer.
What do you expect from an Alice?
No, listen. No, we don't know whether that's a good answer or a bad answer, but that's his answer. So you've got rubber, rub-a-dub-dub, and rub-down. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own, Ronnie. What would you like to do?
I'll take Richard's rub-down.
Take Richard's rub-down.
I'll have you through in 30 minutes.
He does it with perfumed oils and all that. It's very interesting.
Gardenia like behind my ear.
Okay. Rubdown is the answer we're looking for. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response. Rub out is a good answer. Okay, very good answer. Still no rubdown. Let's see if it's under the $250 response. Rubdown it is. You've got it. Congratulations. Okay. Now, before we go on, what do you think is under the $500?
Rub-a-dub-dub.
Yeah, you think rub-a-dub-dub is under? Yeah. Here it is, a $500 response. Rub-a-dub-dub is right. Audience is right all along. Got a very smart bunch out there. Okay, now you've got $250. That means you're going to be playing for 10 times that amount, or... $2,500. Remember to collect. You got to match one celebrity head-to-head. It has to be exact. Choose one now, please.
Richard, please.
Richard, it is. You face me if you would, please. Alice, Marjorie, Charlie, whatever. He's going to write his answer.
His name is Evelyn. He told you that before.
No. This is Ronnie here, and that's Richard. Born blank. That's B-O-R-N blank. Born blank. There. May I have this dance? Okay, Richard has finished his answer, and now, Ronnie, we need a response from you that you think every other celebrity to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Good luck, Paul. Here we go. Everybody but Dickie. While the Lone Ranger was asleep, Tonto got up and blanked him. While the Lone Ranger was asleep, Tonto got up and blanked him. You thinking about that, Paul? Okay.
Something strange about that Tonto.
All right, Brett and Larry are ready. Charles, we're waiting for you. And let's see. Elaine is finished. Kaye is finished.
It's hard to get Charles to put his answer in the slot, dear.
Yes. Well, he'll get the hang of it by the time we're in our second year.
I speak very little English.
All right, Paul Fisher. While the Lone Ranger was asleep, Tonto got up and blanked him.
I'm going to go with scalped.
Scalped him. All right. The first time we get an answer other than scalp, the game is over. He's got a match.
What do you say, Kimo Sabe?
It's been wonderful knowing you, Paul. Creamed.
It creamed him. So that's congratulations. Stand by for a moment here. We've got to say goodbye to Paul Fisher. Your wife is still smiling down there.
It's been a delightful experience.
Well, it's been a pleasure for us to meet you as your wife and her mother and cousins. And we brought the whole family here for good luck. Good luck to you, Paul Fisher. $10,200. Thank you, Paul. Well, Ronnie, Paul has left a very, very happy man with all of that money, and we're going to see how happy you're going to be now.
I hope so.
You're the champ. You've got $100 to your credit now. You're going to have a go at over $5,000 in the big money super match here. Are you ready for that?
I sure am. I've got my lucky gardenia.
Okay. May I have a little whiff of your gardenia?
Yes.
Great odor, isn't it?
Oh, it's my favorite.
All right, here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, Ronnie, and we got their best response to this. Rub blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second most frequent response, $250. Third, $100. Which celebrities would you like a little assist from?
Chuck, please. Charles.
Oh, Chuck. Charles. She calls you Chuck.
Because when I wear ruffles, I get very confused.
I'll buy that, with or without the ruffles.
Now, I say, Chuck would say an answer like rub-a-dub.
Rub-a-dub. Okay, so Chuck says rub-a-dub. How come you're
like... that gardenia in my face, lady, yes, if my name is Chuck. Throw a brick my way.
Chuck, may I ask a question? Your light is on. How come?
Because I'm Chuck. That's a stupid question.
You've never touched
it. It was kissed, is what Tonto did.
Oh, I see.
Tonto right
kissed
on
the Lone Ranger. Yeah, Chuck, that's not his. Yeah, now let's get another one, shall we?
I'm sorry. From now on, you'll be Charles. How
you
about
say
Dickie?
Say anything you want.
He's only kidding.
It's your gardenia.
Okay. Dickie?
Yeah, something.
In this case, I've got to point out...
Do you want my ruffles?
That you're not playing a game called What's in a Name.
Mr. Dawson really prefers Richard, not Dickie.
Or Chuck. I don't mind Chuck.
He doesn't like Dickie.
I don't even mind Evelyn. I just hate Dickie.
No, we're only
fun. Please call me sir. Rub down.
Rub down.
Very good.
One more.
Larry, please.
Larry.
Go on, Larry.
Is that your real name?
No, my real name is Alice.
I thought it was Charles.